But first tonight, tributes for one of Australia's most influential and well-loved Prime Minister's wives.
Former PM Gough Whitlam is mourning the passing of his wife Margaret, who died in hospital this morning after suffering a fall last month.
Margaret Whitlam was by every measure a woman of substance. When her husband won office in 1972, she shrugged off the usual role of prime ministerial wife, using her voice to forthrightly champion causes close to her heart.
I don't mind talking to her, as long as they listen to what I'm saying.
The daughter of a judge, she was a champion swimmer, competing at the Empire Games of 1938. She married Gough in 1942.
Margaret Whitlam was a truly remarkable Australian, and she was a great role model for Australian women. She proved that it was possible to be one half of an enduring partnership, but at the same time be very much a woman in your own right.
She was a great patron of the arts. She was a woman of style and substance, and we should mourn her passing.
Marie Coleman worked with Mrs. Whitlam on the Social Justice Commission in the 1970s. She describes her as a compliment to a more reserved Gough.
Margaret always had that lovely common touch of being able to encourage people just to talk without feeling in any way overawed or uncomfortable.
Just a few weeks from what would have been their 70th anniversary, Mr. Whitlam described his wife as the love of his life. She encouraged and sustained me and our four children, their families and many other people in a life full of engagement with Australians from all walks of life.
She will be missed by the whole Australian nation, but she will be mostly missed by the Whitlam family.
She was named an Australian National Living Treasure in 1997. Margaret Whitlam was 92.